Good afternoon. Welcome back to Five Live. If you live on the east side, there's a new kid on the block. Atrium Restaurant is here. Hunter and Gregory, you're going to explain everything. But first, how did you decide on this location?
It's a great neighborhood spot. It needed something new.
I feel like there's a lot of great restaurants in Los Feliz.
There are. But it needs a little bit of an update, and we wanted to kind of be the new kids on the block, if you will.
And you guys work together. Hunter, what do you do?
I'm a chef.
And for dinner? For that? Brunch? All of the above?
Yeah, all of the above. So anything that's not pastry or bread, I handle.
And you are pastry and bread.
Yeah, pastry and bread. Also his twin brother at this point.
Fair,
so yeah,
fair.
We live together at the restaurant, so it's,
our DNA is combining.
One thing we were talking about before we get into the food was the location and how kind of hard it is to find, and I want people to go there. So explain exactly where it is.
It's tricky, but it's worth the surprise.
It's worth the journey.
We do have a beautiful sign, but it's visible from a very narrow alleyway. So we're right on Vermont, right between Melbourne and some other street.
It's there.
I don't know. It's 1816.
Next to the theater is the most important.
Exactly. Yes. 1816 North Vermont. So we have a beautiful long patio. You see lovely string lights over, great furniture, lots of plants, all that good stuff. And then a nice sort of glowing pink, orange slices shaped sign.
Right. And so if you're curious, those lights are a very good signal for where it is. You'll see them in an alleyway, and it's not creepy at all.
Absolutely.
It's not a creepy alley.
We have
but
a valet.
Go in.
It's full of beautiful, totally normal people. They're welcoming. We usually have a host out there to sort of usher you back.
Yes, to grab people.
Yep.
It's very formal in that regard. You get sort of an escort back to the dining room, and then it opens up. We have a beautiful barrel ceiling, lots of warm wood, lots of plants in there, so it's a very nice
surprise.
Yeah, and
I was curious, can you eat along the alleyway?
Absolutely.
Yes. Okay, great.
Yeah, we got heaters out there. It's beautiful by day. It's completely different by night. Yeah. The restaurant sort of has two faces. Mm-hmm. It's very like light and airy and sort of Mediterranean, and then once the sun goes down, it gets sort of sultry, dark, and spooky, and like totally nice, well, very grown up.
Mine is the spooky part.
I was gonna say, spooky.
It's a great date place because it's small enough and it's intimate enough, and the food is amazing. So if you have nothing to talk about, you can at least talk about the dishes.
Yeah, totally. Absolutely. Totally intimate, beautiful booths.
Yeah.
So picture yourself in a big, like, comfy green booth.
Maybe no, like but an they're, atrium?
Oh my God, in an atrium.
Yes, thank you.
That's why we call it atrium.
Get paid the big bucks. Okay, so I've been there, I've tasted your dinner. You guys also have brunch.
Correct.
Like, who plays more of a role when it comes to brunch? Because I always think of French toast or something more pastry-ish,
correct.
But how do you guys work that out?
So, I mean, there are a couple egg dishes that you would expect from brunch.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, you'll see a lot more pastry-oriented things at brunch. One of our really awesome things that we do there, besides granola, it's seeded, vegan option. But we also do a cornmeal pancake that is now morphed into a waffle. Mm. So it's very crunchy, lots of little bits and textures. But the great thing about it is it's gluten-free. So it's another option for people who might
you
have that.
You guys are so LA. You're thinking of everyone.
We try to.
Yeah, vegan, gluten-free. Does that ever become hard when you're a chef?
It's hard, but as long as you're expecting it, you know, and you sort of work that, there's plenty of ways to get around it without making a lesser product. Whenever we have someone come in, they always feel very put out by having a food allergy or restriction or something. I always say, like, we've been waiting for you this entire time. Like, come on in.
What you need.
I've been waiting for you,
you know,
so just come in.
Though, because so many people in LA have dietary restrictions or are doing something this month that they weren't last month, and you want to go out with your friends, but you don't want to be that person that's like,
okay. Yeah.
I mean, we are that neighborhood spot. We're not trying to be the greatest restaurant in LA, but we're trying to make a statement in the sense that we want to be inclusive to everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so what'd you bring in right now? This is all part of the dinner, right?
Right. These are some of our bigger hits.
Run me through the whole gamut.
Yeah, so over here we have our octopus tostada. So this is sustainably fished Spanish octo that we cooked down for a long time until it's fork tender. We toss it in an al pastor marinade, so a lot of achiote and chili in there, and then we grill it. And it has a lovely cabbage slaw tossed with sort of a salsa verde underneath with some grilled pineapple
that
on it.
That sounds like a lot of flavor.
It's a lot, but it's delicious. So sort of going back to, you know, those late night taco runs, seeing the man flick the pineapple off the trompo, and really Tacos Leo's.
Oh, okay.
Yes. They're fantastic. But very like familiar flavors, and that's what we're all about. I also believe in like full flavor. I really want to create menu items that really cement themselves in your brain, so you crave them and you have to come back for it and you're addicted.
Okay, so what was the choice over maybe doing it with fish instead of octopus?
I love octopus. Ellie loves octopus.
Yeah, I noticed that for a lot of people that come in, that's something on all of their menus.
Yeah, it's nice. It's nice and meaty, and it's sort of a different texture, but really, like, before I moved to LA, I've never eaten so much octopus. I always get it. It's generally done pretty well around
octopus?
Here. It's crazy.
Crazy. Andy, do you like octopus?
Love it.
Yes.
Big fan.
I love it.
Only know, well, I'm not a microphone That microphone for me, but you know, I only started eating it when I moved to LA.
Really?
So I didn't really even ever know about
this
it.
This is strange. A weird trend, an underground trend I didn't know about.
Yeah. Trends.
LA loving octopus.
We're ahead of it. but it's fantastic and it's beautiful to share. Nice bright flavors, and it's a little bit spicy, a little bit sweet. You got smoky and crunchy, and all those things are working together. So that's sort of what we aim for. Here we have one of our entrees. So this is a vegan entree. I really wanted to create something that's like center of the plate and as impressive as a big old steak for our non-meat eating friends out there. So we get fantastic cauliflower. We go through hundreds of heads a week. I sell so much of this. I think this may be our number one selling entree.
I've had it and it's amazing. And I'd like you to show us how to make this up. Because if you walked in here and you first looked at it, it looks like meat. So you wouldn't know that it's an actual cauliflower.
So this is great cauliflower. We get it from Underwood Farms. It's delivered 2 to 3 times a week. This is a purple cauliflower. So it's sort of an heirloom breed. It's a little bit sweeter.
How much cauliflower would you say you go through a week?
Like 120 heads.
Oh my God.
About 6 feet worth, 6 feet of cases. but it's sort of inspired by like the, you know, we are in Los Feliz, East Hollywood, sort of like the Armenian sort of Eastern communities around there. Essentially just sort of ate a bunch of Zanku chicken while we were doing construction. I was like, this marinade is delicious.
We got a huge Zanku fan base over there in the corner.
Yeah.
It's
some spicy stuff. I
love
it.
You know what's cool, though, is that a lot of times you see cauliflower on a menu and it's like deep fried with sauces, and you're like, this is not the point of this.
Yeah. The buffalo cauliflower thing is like, just eat the buffalo sauce. Like, I don't know what to tell you.
Drink it.
It's pretty rough.
It's
pretty rough. But this is, you know, it's adult. It's shareable and it's sort of interactive too, which is very of the now.
And you don't often see vegan plates shareable. It's for that vegan.
Correct.
And they're like, don't touch.
But this is like good enough. And honestly, we don't get that many vegans in. When we do, we're like, great. Again, we've been expecting you. but this is like, cool. You just want some nice vegetables.
Just to leave
or
a trail of it.
Yeah.
Hey, can you break that up? Can we start looking and see what that
is? So we have beautiful tomatoes in here. I'm gonna borrow this.
That is totally fine.
We're still getting them from up north. They're dry farm tomatoes and they're still delicious. As soon as they stop being delicious, we'll pull them off the menu.
Chef, can you hold it up to camera a little bit?
Sure.
Do you want me to put it back on this? Can you cut it that way if it's up there?
I can try.
Okay.
there's also pickled green tomatoes, which we sort of use all over the menu. It's on our burger, but we already try to utilize things and be sort of low waste. So one of the joys of my life is stabbing these things with a steak knife and then encouraging the more timid members of my staff to stab it.
I'm sure that's satisfying.
And really see what they're made of, because I know there's a little bit of craziness in them all. But really, the goal, what you want to do here is cut this into manageable pieces. And then we have an Armenian salad around here. Mm-hmm. So there's dates from down Coachella. We have the last of the season's shishito peppers, some onions, some radishes, and then a whole bunch of herbs. I really believe in herbs, and I believe in acid. And that keeps you guys eating full but thirsty, you know?
Yeah. So. Which is cool, because I was going to say, you're not leaving too full. There's always room for dessert.
There's always room for
dessert. You're never going to be over the top where there's not enough space. It's almost part of the whole meal.
Right.
You have to get something from that dessert menu. So what did you bring?
So, I mean, I guess I brought the passion fruit custard. It goes with lemongrass custard on the bottom, passion fruit gelée on the top. Then it's a candied cashew tossed with a little bit of minced lime leaf.
Wow,
and then at the restaurant, we'll top it off with lime leaf and cashew milk sorbet.
Can
a little bit more lime leaf. Yeah, of course. It's melting a little bit, but that's okay. What's great about it is because one thing that we're trying to emphasize is people tend to have this idea that dessert is a little bit heavy. Mm-hmm. It has to be that chocolate fudge cake or something else. We really wanted this restaurant to be very market driven. A couple of years ago, I made the decision to make everything from the market and put it into my dessert. And what is so great about that is that it complements Hunter's food so well. I generally tend to also love high acid, not so much sugar, and something that's fresh and refreshing. Mm-hmm. And passion fruit is the perfect way to start your new year.
That, to me, seems the difficult way, but the better way to do things. Are you challenged in any way when it comes to making something sweeter without all of the sugar?
Yeah, absolutely. But that's the perfect part of my job.
Yeah.
I love being challenged. And what's great is trying to complement Hunter's food. And that's really what's great about the partnership.
Do you guys do a lot of seasonal stuff when produce comes out that's different from
Totally.
Summer?
Yeah.
So will we see this menu kind of shift?
Absolutely. Yeah, probably within the next month you'll start to see some huge shifts, but we'll always have big bangers on the menu.
So get it now.
Yeah. Get it now.
Yeah, get all
What will happen?
Get all the tasting in. Okay, Atrium is on Vermont Follow. the lights that are down the alley and you'll make your way into there. It is exactly that, a giant atrium. The bar is beautiful. Yep. I think we have some photos. Do we have photos from inside the restaurant?
We will. You'll be seeing them.
Okay, perfect. Hunter, Gregory, thank you so much for coming in. I'm going to start with the cauliflower. Is this tempting to you guys? Are you guys going to come up here and eat this? Okay, cool. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Thanks.